Welcome to the Minnesota Department of Agriculture's presentation on nitrogen fertilizer fall application restrictions. Areas subject to fall application restrictions were posted on the MDA's website on January 15, 2020. The link to the website is listed here, and the website will be updated annually on January 15th. On September 1st, 2020, the fall application restrictions begin. The authority for the rule comes from the Groundwater Protection Act of 1989, which is Minnesota Statute 103H. The act resulted in this groundwater degradation prevention goal: enhanced regulatory authority for fertilizer practices and the development of a nitrogen fertilizer management plan by the MDA. The Nitrogen Fertilizer Management Plan is the state's blueprint for minimizing groundwater impacts from the use of nitrogen fertilizer. The plan has voluntary and regulatory components such as the rule. From 2010 to 2015, the MDA worked with an advisory committee to revise the 1990 NFMP. The key goals of the Nitrogen Fertilizer Management Plan involve science-based practices, focusing on areas vulnerable to groundwater contamination, and working with local farmers and agronomists to address nitrate in groundwater. Although much of the attention is on the rule, the NFMP emphasizes prevention. Work began on the groundwater protection rule when the revision of the nitrogen fertilizer management plan was completed in 2015. The MDA followed Minnesota's rulemaking process and developed the rule with extensive public input, holding listening sessions across the state. Significant changes were based on the comments, and the rule became law in June 2019. The rule applies to the use of nitrogen fertilizer because that's what the MDA has the authority to regulate. The rule does not regulate manure. There are two parts to the rule. The first is the fall application restrictions in vulnerable groundwater areas, and the second is responding to public wells with high nitrate. Part one of the rule restricts the application of nitrogen fertilizer in the fall and on frozen soils in areas with vulnerable groundwater or protection areas around public wells with high nitrate, called DWSMAs, or drinking water supply management areas. In this map, the vulnerable groundwater areas are in purple, and the drinking water supply management areas are in green, although they're hard to see at this scale. About 12.6% of Minnesota's cropland is vulnerable. Part two of the groundwater protection rule is a process for working with local farmers to reduce nitrate in public water supply wells that have high nitrate. We won't be discussing part two in this presentation. If you farm in a vulnerable groundwater area, there are restrictions on the application of nitrogen fertilizer in the fall and on frozen soils. Vulnerable groundwater criteria include coarse textured soils, soils with shallow bedrock, or karst geology. These are determined quarter section by quarter section, so that if more than 50% of a quarter section is vulnerable, fall application will not be allowed in the entire quarter section, and if less than 50% of a quarter section is vulnerable, fall application is allowed in the entire quarter section. The MDA website has a zoomable interactive vulnerable groundwater area map. Drinking water supply management areas for municipal water systems with nitrate at or higher than 5.4 milligrams per liter are subject to this part of the rule. The drinking water supply management areas subject to the restrictions may change from year to year. What is the drinking water supply management area? The blue line shows the wellhead protection area, which is the source of a city's water. This map shows a 10-year time of travel boundary, and that means that it takes about 10 years for the water to get from the edge of the blue line to the public well. The green line shows the drinking water supply management area and lines up with recognizable boundaries such as roads. Nitrogen fertilizer application restrictions apply in drinking water supply management areas where municipal public wells have nitrate levels of 5.4 milligrams per liter or higher. The nitrate data comes from the Minnesota Department of Health. Areas within a DWSMA which are low risk to groundwater contamination in the Wellhead Protection Plan are exempt from fall application restrictions. This is based on a detailed evaluation of the soils and geology. These may change when a Wellhead Protection Plan is updated. Parts of the state are excluded from fall application restrictions. These include counties with low leaching potential based on precipitation and evapotranspiration rates in a short planting season. This is shown in yellow and mainly covers northwest Minnesota. And counties where less than 3% of the land is used for cropland. This is shown in blue and is generally in northeast Minnesota and Ramsey County. These are exceptions where farmers can apply nitrogen fertilizer in the fall. To develop this list, the MDA consulted the University of Minnesota and listened to input from public meetings. University of Minnesota nitrogen fertilizer rate guidelines must be followed if farmers fall apply to these crops. There is an exception for applying MAP or DAP or micronutrient fertilizer formulations. Farmers can fall apply nitrogen just so the rate does not exceed an average of 40 pounds per acre in a field. Fields that have had a soil analysis completed by a certified lab and determined to have low or very low phosphorus levels are not subject to the 40 pound per acre rate. The next slides are examples of the interactive map. The map has layers for coarse textured soils, shallow bedrock, and karst geology. These are shown in purple and designated by quarter sections. DWSMAs are also included on the map and are in green. This map shows central Minnesota and the map has been zoomed in and the coarse textured soils layer selected. This map shows southeast Minnesota and the map has been zoomed in and the coarse textured soils and shallow bedrock layers are selected. You can also see the green drinking water supply management areas that are easier to see at this scale. Farmers certified in the Minnesota Ag Water Quality Certification Program are deemed to be in compliance with the rule. Part of the farm operation review process associated with certification is a discussion and evaluation of nitrogen management, including the nitrogen fertilizer best management practices. As of the week of July 27th, 923 producers farming over 637,000 acres were certified in the program. For enforcement, the responsible party is the owner, operator, or agent in charge of cropland. It's the person who makes the decision. MDA staff will enforce the rule, and enforcement will be complaint-driven. The approach is to conduct education and compliance assistance before moving to financial penalties. The penalty amount will depend on the situation and the factors listed here. Thank you for your interest in the presentation. Refer to this website for more detail on the rule and to access the Vulnerable Groundwater Area Map.